Well, in Virginia, a 14-year-old student was named America's top young scientist for developing soap that treats cancer. Heman Bekele entered the 3M Young Scientist Challenge. The competition invites middle school students from across the country to identify an everyday problem and create a video offering a solution. And he joins us right now to talk more about this. Thanks for being with us.
Welcome, Heman.
Thank you so much for having me.
How did you come up with this idea? Take us through your process.
Sure. So I started the project about a year and a half ago, and this was even before I even discovered the 3M Young Scientist Challenge. I was really just doing it for fun, just out of my curiosity. And I was really just inspired by growing up in Ethiopia, seeing people constantly working under the hot sun. It really led me to take action because skin cancer is a really prevalent issue all over the world. And so I started to do a little bit of development on different types of skin cancer treatments and what's out there right now in comparison to what I was trying to create. And I came upon a bar of soap as the ideal solution because it is really affordable in comparison to something like a surgery or any other topical application. And so then I started working on that project. And over the span of about a year and a half, I worked on developing it and then creating the video for the challenge. And then I came out as a finalist. And then there was that final event where I had to give a presentation and I was declared the winner.
And I know one thing that's influenced you is that you spent your early childhood in Ethiopia and saw firsthand how complex finding a cure that works across populations across the world can be. Tell us a little bit more about that.
Yeah, so that's definitely a really good question because, like, even just growing up, it's not that I saw skin cancer. It's that I saw that there were just so many people who either were living on the poverty line or were getting so many different issues in regards to sun exposure and working long, long hours under the hot sun. And then that really did influence me because, you know, growing up, I didn't think much of it. But then when I got to that age where I really started to be really passionate about science, I realized how big of an issue that really was. So then that's what really led me to take action and think of a problem that actually has an international, global effect on it. And so not just something that could help one specific region, but could actually just help everyone.
And Heman, you're 14, is that right?
Yeah, I'm 14 years old.
And so it's lipid nanoparticles, is that right? What is a lipid nanoparticle?
Mm-hmm. So I can break it down for you. It's actually really, really simple because if you think about it, the bar of soap isn't really thought of as something that can be super medicinal because once you wash it away, the thought there is that it's just gone. But by using this lipid-based nanoparticle formulation, what you can actually do is you can wash away the soaps and the suds, but that lipid-based nanoparticle will actually keep all of the key elements to it stuck to your skin at a very small molecular level. So you're still able to get that impact after you wash away the soap, but it's a very, very small residual effect. And so it won't really be like sticky or you won't really see it in your skin. It's just gonna be internally helping you.
And it's that residual that gets absorbed that then treats the skin cancer.
Exactly.
Heman, you are impressive. There's nothing better than a 14-year-old telling us it's super easy to understand lipid nanoparticles, and he's going to explain it to us. So thank you very much for once again reminding us how far we still have to go. You're an inspiration. We appreciate you joining us this morning.
Yeah, thank you so much for having me. This was great.
Well, you did a great job explaining it.
Yeah.
I understand. I learned a lot. And for more information, you can check out the screen there with more info on that. And once again, thank you so much for joining us this morning.